Are you married?
Look, don't ask
you. You love people are still waiting for his documentary.
Do you love your wife?
Do you love your wife?
Why would
you marry
someone I don't love?
Right, how would you feel with her going back to
India? If a woman had sex with four men,
yeah, who's
the dad?
Nobody's going to know.
Who's the dad?
I've been in this situation.
Go to the
GP. They didn't have GPs back then.
Okay.
What did they do?
You go and have a mutter marriage, back in the time of the Prophet. Yeah? But when it was allowed during the war, that's fine. Yeah? What if the woman has an STD? She gives it to the man, and he gives it to all his four wives.
Well, they must have been a few weeks.
You
feel guilty of
it? You don't look like a Muslim.
Yeah, I'm like
Muslim. Pepper boy.
Yeah. That's good.
I'm a Christian. Okay. Well, people can come in the name of Christianity, but that doesn't mean they're true Christians.
I'm a Satanist.
A what?
Satanist.
What's that? You believe in the devil. Why is it Satan? Why do you believe in the devil?
Because he's
cool. See?
Jesus is like a hippie, man. The devil, so everything cool belongs to God. I mean, to the devil, sorry.
Like the last plague is
the last. The only devil one.
All my favorite people are going to hell. Hitler, Stalin, Bush.
Well, you're going to have a good party.
Yeah.
Just take some barbecue sticks over.
So we're going to have a debate, me and Paperboy and Ali Dawa. So we're going to discuss the Trinity and Tawheed from the scripture or Christian and Islamic sources and see which one makes more sense.
Oh, he's only to mock dicks like that. He is a dick, isn't
he? What did he mock?
Rob, he mocked like...
Thank you.
Like,
you're a sincere man.
Yeah, but he did.
From this day onwards, you know why? Not because you're attacking people, but you're fair.
I disagree with you badly, but I'm speaking the truth.
That's why you're a sincere man.
Yeah? He is a dick for doing what he did with the videos. Right.
Islamicize me.
Yeah, if you're going to do... No, I'm not, brother. I'm a Christian man. Well, my family wish I was, but I'm not.
But wish you were what? I thought you were
Christian. No, I am going to be one day.
So what are you? You're confused. You're sounding confused.
Yeah, I am confused. And that's why I come here. No, no. Only if I get three wives and 72 virgins, then yes.
Get four wives.
Yeah, well I will.
But you need to treat them equally.
Well, if you like that Satanist...
None of that.
Yeah. If you like that Satanist Las Vegas living, you will love Islam, yes. So
not really, because it's not easy to be a Muslim. Christianity, you just say, oh, Jesus died for my sins.
You can have four wives.
That's it, finish.
You can have four wives.
Brother, so my father, my mother,
and then when you go to heaven, you have more wives.
Real talk. Man to man. Are you telling me,
Real talk.
If you had the option,
yes.
If your wife was okay with it, you had the fun, you had the time.
Yes.
Be honest with me.
Yes.
If you're, look, be honest with me. You're a man.
I'm going to be honest.
You're a man, brother. If your wife was calm with it, would you get married again?
Yeah, but listen, I'm going to be honest.
One second.
Real talk,
brother.
If my wife was
calm.
If my wife allowed it, I would. But.
Wait.
But. Would rather do what makes God happy. But and if he's allowed me to have one wife, then I'm happy with one wife.
If God is happy with you treating two women equally, would you do it?
Ali, ask me to have 14.
I probably would.
Ali, but ask me to say.
Paperboy,
yes,
you got my full attention.
But this is the thing.
Because you're honest. Yeah?
Okay.
And can I tell you something? Every time, even when I was praying now, and I'm not saying this for the sake of it, I swear to God I prayed for you, yeah? And I'm sure you prayed for this.
Okay.
Yeah? You can laugh as much as you like. I swear to God, when I was there, I prayed for your guidance. You know why? Look, we speak to Daniel, we speak to Coco, Popcorn, yeah? I'm joking. We speak to all of these mans, yeah?
Yeah?
I don't see them to be sincere. I don't care what anyone says, yeah? Same argument, same hatred, Lizzie, Hartun, all of them, yeah? But you, even I was just told today, don't speak to them. I said, no, let me speak to them, yeah? Okay, so with me, Baba, I'm not going to give up on you until you give up on yourself.
Ali.
I'm not giving up on you.
Same, thank you. You want
Ali,
me to go
until
heaven?
Until your eyes are open.
Thank you. It's the same, that's what I feel about you as well, yeah? I hope God opens your eyes because that's how you feel the same about me.
Ali,
so,
are you married?
Look, don't ask
you. You love people are still waiting for his documentary.
Do you love your wife?
Do you love your wife?
Why would I marry someone I don't love?
Right. How would you feel with her going to bed with somebody else?
Okay, that's a good question. But that is a good question.
Because it would destroy my wife.
No,
I would never do it.
Hear me out. That's another topic I'm going to come to. That's a whole different argument.
Because it's not.
Is it within a woman's nature to get another husband?
According to who, though?
Of course it is.
Yeah, that's because he made a good question. Now, let me ask you a sincere question. Let me ask you a question. Did you ask me? Is it right that you can have four wives, but your wife can't have four, three other husbands?
Let me tell you why. Okay. Because this was not a topic.
I know, but you asked a question, so I can ask you one.
Yeah, so that's what I'm going to answer. Yeah, okay. So let me ask you guys a question. Okay. If a woman has intercourse with four men.
Yeah, okay, the baby. I get it.
One second. If God has legislated something, just because something doesn't, like for example, you are told, I'm sure in the scripture you would deny, that we can go to war. You believe? I believe in the scripture. I'm saying, I'm ordered that if there is an oppressive army, like the Prophet, peace be upon him, he was oppressed for 10 plus years. His companions were killed, persecuted, yeah? For 10 plus years. He did not get a revelation to fight back until Surah Hajj verse 39 was revealed. The permission to fight has been given now. So when you're fighting, obviously you don't want to get your hands chopped up. You don't want to die. It's hard. Yeah, it's hard to go to battle, yes? I'm sure you haven't got to battle, but come on, you've been in fights, yeah?
I understand.
So,
but let's stick to the women.
No, but sticking, but it comes back to this. Okay. The issue is, just because something doesn't seem nice to the ear, I'm going to go to war, man might get killed, it does not negate the fact that that is wrong. Yeah? So just as because we're ordered to marry four women, it does not mean the revelation is wrong. It doesn't mean. Just because a woman is jealous doesn't mean the revelation is wrong. If the Bible said marry...
But is it fair?
No. Who has said fair and equality is given? So for example, if you have a need of two breads, my man needs four. It's not equality me to say, okay, here's two for me and two for me. It's four. I'm not saying, by the way,
yeah, but there's some women that want three more.
Let me tell you something, within a nature of a woman,
okay, according to you,
look, I'm not going to be generalized.
Okay.
Are there some women out there that would, I don't know, would want simultaneously more women? I don't know.
Give me their number.
I don't know. But what I'm saying is, within a woman's nature is one man. She knows one man. Yeah? But for a man, look, for a man, from
that's
history,
a bit of a generalization.
From history, I'm saying there might be some odd ones out there, here and there, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, but you know, in your Christianity, in history, many of them had many wives.
Yeah, but for example, like some of those women probably had four, five, six husbands.
No. Mutter, look, you cannot be married simultaneously.
Yeah, but one out of different men, though, isn't it?
No, you can't. That's not allowed for prohibited, yeah? But that's not our argument today, yeah? Just briefly to answer the question, yeah? But moving on to our main topic, yeah? So before I start, yeah, I want to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All praises, glory, and gratitude belong to God Almighty. Okay.
I don't think you sufficiently answered that question, though.
But the thing is, because we've got to,
answer that question, that's on that point. Okay. Whether it's fair.
Okay, so I'll still start with the name of
the question. If you love your wife,
so...
Let me just answer that about the equality.
Would you care for a female?
No, inequality.
Give me a female. I care about the Sharia, God's commandments have not only come for my wife, but for the rights of other females. Yeah? So for example, if I live in a village or a town, and there is more men than women, yes? Hear me out. It's not... Excuse me? There's time of living, man. Do you know how many more... There is, and I don't deny, there are some places where there are more women than men. But what I'm trying to say to you is this year, that God Almighty has sent these legislations to cater for everybody. So if everybody's married...
Specific time.
No. It depends. You can use it, yeah? If every man and woman has got married, those women have sexual needs. They have a man, another woman. Some say it's not just sexual. I need a companion. I need a man for my children, yeah? So Allah has legislated this because a lot of the time men die in war. Go to America, majority of the inmates are males. Go to America, there's 28 million gays. So you got women there who are burning. They're saying, look, man, we've got needs. So Allah has, God Almighty has legislated a solution. Because otherwise we can turn to God and say, hold on a second, we have these problems. What's the solution? This is why Islam, one of the reasons why I chose Islam, because Islam hasn't come in a pacifist way of, you know, everything is all, rosy. No. Islam is real. It's the bitter truth that it's hard to swallow. So that's why some people come and say, oh, but what is this? Why does Islam say this? Because Islam is being real. It's saying, look, this is what's happening and this is what's going to happen. So that's the reason why, for example, the issue of woman more than more husband. If she had sex with four men, who's the father?
Yeah, but does that stand for this day?
Biologically, that's point. No,
yeah.
So then, if a woman has what?
If a woman had sex with four men,
who's the dad?
She's nobody's gonna know. Who's the dad?
I've been in this situation.
They didn't have GPs back then.
Okay.
What did they do? That's one of the reasons why, if a man has four wives, do you know who the father is? So, that's one reason. I'm giving you the wisdom behind it. Yeah, I don't know. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Okay. That's one reason. And also, it's just very recent. In today's time that we live, this feminist movement thing of, no, you know, only my man. Look, there's a lot of non-Muslims who practice polygamy.
Yeah.
A lot, yeah?
Yeah.
And Mormons, yeah?
Yeah.
I have to big them up. You know why? Because they say, oh, your co how do you feel about your co-wife? She goes, you're not my co-wife, she's my co-sister. I had to respect, yeah? Because she was like, that's my co-sister.
Yeah, but ain't never about stolen.
It's not for everyone. Allah says in the Quran, marry two, three, and four. If you can't be just, marry one.
Okay.
And you want to find a statement, marry one.
But the reason why I'll point out that point about who's the father, and the reason why I brought out Mutter, for example, you go and have a Mutter marriage back in the time of the Prophet. Yeah? But when it was allowed during the war, that's fine. Yeah? What if the woman has an STD? She gives it to the man and he gives it to all his four wives. Okay. And then what?
Okay. Firstly, why does she have an STD?
Yeah. Because STDs have always existed in humanity.
No, why did she go sleeping around?
A stick.
Yeah, under Mutter, you can sleep with someone for 3 days.
Someone before pre-Islam, before Islam, could have done that and repented. She's still my mother.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm trying to say?
But that's what I'm saying.
You need to tell me that there's a correlation that Islam causes.
No, but I'm just saying, because you're giving me a logical reason as to why, like, who's the father.
Yes.
So I'm saying, you go to war, there's a beautiful woman.
Yes.
And everyone likes a particular woman.
Yes.
Let's say somehow she contracts an STD,
right?
Or she has an STD or whatever. Because STDs, syphilis has existed for exactly the longest of times throughout history. You contract it here, and then you go, let's say you have four, and then you go and give it to your four wives.
Yeah, but what's that got to do with the issue of Mutter?
Because Mutter is, for example, like, prostitution has a very high correlation with sexual diseases. If you look at any sexual health study, so obviously Mutter was a time was you could marry someone for 3 days, right?
No, minimum of three days. We don't know. I don't know.
Yeah,
do you know?
A minute, yeah.
No.
I don't know.
I don't know. I haven't looked into it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. It was temporary.
I don't know why it was legislated, what it was for, and why it was forbidden. I don't know.
You don't know anything. Okay.
No. I don't know.
So
I know that it was forbidden.
Yes.
So the question is like alcohol. Yeah.
Yes.
The companions used to drink alcohol. They used to come to prayer. Alcohol.
Okay.
Drink it drunk. That's what Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said. Do not come to prayer drunk. That was the basis of getting them into the right state of mind.
So,
because Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who's one of the biggest scholars in Islam, she said that if revelation came down with halal and haram, nobody would have accepted Islam.
Okay.
Because it was too hard on them, yeah?
Okay.
But the revelation came down with paradise, heaven, do you get what I'm trying to say?
But 2 points. One, let me just start with the halal and haram thing. But when the Egyptians came out of Egypt, God gave the Torah to Moses and they had to follow it, nothing about halal or haram. That was given to him. So why is it now Allah, during the time of Muhammad, is given these exceptions? For them, they had the ways of the Egyptians and whatever. Their lifestyle. They didn't have the Torah then.
Of course.
Right? Why is it then Allah would give them the Torah and say, guys, you have to follow these 613 laws, no question about it. There's no probation period or anything. But then now, Allah is allowing...
Because just the way, for example, Moses' miracles were different to Jesus' miracles, was different to Muhammad's miracles.
Okay.
Because at that time, for example, at the time of Moses, it was magic.
Okay.
So God would not go and send Moses the Quran because it wasn't poetry. You get it?
No, but my point is they had to follow the laws. There was no probationary period.
There was certain laws and legislation God commanded Moses,
but
he did not command Jesus. And he did not command Prophet Muhammad. It's not that God changes his mind, but he caters for each specific time. You know what I'm trying to say? So Moses' time, if there was a specific situation, God's going to command that. He's going to send that miracle in the sea. In Jesus' time, he was his miraculous birth. Yeah, healing the blind. You know what I'm trying to say?
So,
back to the original argument. You know, I think it's equality for women. It's equality to women. Equality doesn't mean it's justice. Yeah, but is a woman not equal to a man? If I'm allowed four wives in Islam, is a woman not equal to a man? If I'm allowed as many women as I want, she's not.
Okay, if that's the case, for example, equality doesn't mean it's justice. Yeah, so for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that, for example, if you fear that your wife, for example, is cheating behind your back.
No, we're not cheating. She deserves my respect.
No, hear me out. But nobody said don't respect her. He said you don't respect her.
I just want to make a point.
Marrying again does not mean it's disrespectful. This is a new phenomenon in today's age that it's a, oh no, if you love me. No. Listen, where did this all come up from?
I don't believe that.
Fam, 100 years ago, this was not a problem.
I don't believe that.
It was not a
problem. I believe everyone had feelings back then.
But you see, that's a subjective notion that's been brought up today.
I don't think it. I don't believe it.
It is.
I believe we've had emotions, the same emotions.
No. Brother, no. Okay.
If
no,
somebody dies, you want to cry.
No, I agree with you. Yeah, I agree with you.
But if I brought another wife, my wife would be devastated.
Okay, so what we're saying is, the Sharia says, for example, if your wife...
But she's inequality to me.
No,
she's not equal to me if that's the case.
Hear me, yeah? This is an in-depth topic, yeah? There's a lot of matters regarding
it. Yes, but I'm trying to get to the
Okay, one second. Let me tell you something, yeah? That would maybe seal the whole issue, yeah? I'm not going to ask you personally, yeah? Are there people out there who cheat on their wives?
Me.
That's the reason you shouldn't do that. You should get married again. This is my brother.
No, but I don't, because it'll fuck everything up.
No, hear me out. This is exactly what I'm talking about. Hear me out, yeah? You are a man who has a sexual drive.
A big one.
Okay, a big one, okay. The Sharia is here to help you. So the Sharia says, hear me out. The Sharia says, you're a man with a sex high drive that has a need. Now you're turning to your wife and thinking she's going to kill me.
Yeah.
Should I go cheat on my wife and disobey God's commandment?
Yeah, because she won't know.
But do you see that? So what happens is, with us Muslims, is this, yeah? Either I'm going to make my wife happy at the cost of disobeying God. No. Yeah. So what that would mean is the following, yeah? I'm going to go and cheat on my wife behind her back because I have a high sex drive. I need to get married again.
Good at that.
She's going to kill me.
What?
So, look, if you was a Christian, you're stuck.
I am a Christian.
You're stuck.
Yeah, I'm good at that. One second. I never get caught.
Hear me out. You're a bad Christian. He's cheating on his wife.
He said he's a Satanist.
Okay.
You're going to be a YouTuber, bro.
So, you know what? You're going to die. Your wife's going to kill you.
Brother, I'll
find you. He's going to be a martyr. He's going to be a martyr. So now, hear me out. Islam, this is why I say, Islam is a perfect solution. Yeah? Because if you was a Muslim, number one, you shouldn't cheat on your wife. Big sin, massive sin.
But according to Islam, can you lie to your wife?
Lie about what?
Lie to your wife.
No.
Keep her happy.
Oh, yeah. Look, for example,
so therefore,
hear me out. That's not a lie. We have something called the pink lie. Yeah? So for example,
don't post it, please.
What this means is this, yeah? Is that liar, the Prophet said a Muslim can be anything but to be known as a liar.
Okay.
In general, we don't lie.
If you marry another woman, let me just, do you have to tell your wife your first name?
There's a difference of opinion. Some say you can, some say you can't.
So some say you can't.
Yes.
So your wife would kill you if she found out you followed the opinion that says you can't.
Hear me out.
You don't have to.
Hear me out, because what you're doing is, before I address the issue, you're throwing a lot. So what I'm trying to say is this, yeah? That the solution to this, and see, when you guys do that, I forget my points, yeah? For you, what it means is, the Sharia says, number one, you cannot cheat on your wife. It's a massive, major sin. You have to give her rights. She has sexual rights, yeah? You have rights that you have to spend time with her, take her out. You have to provide for her. You know what this means? That the mahar that you give her, when you marry her, she can say, I want $5,000. You give her that $5,000, that's her money, you can't touch a penny. Even if you're dying out of thirst, she won't give you a penny, she doesn't have to. On top of that, when you're working, you need to look after her while she's shopping. Yeah? Now, once you've done that, now as a man, Allah says to us that the biggest weakness for a man is a woman. It's not weakness, you know what, we all know, yeah? So if you want to get married again, God says, don't disobey my commandment. Don't say, okay, you know what, one God, Allah, my wife is going to kill me. Oh, let her be happy, I'll go and cheat behind her back. No. This is the reason why a lot of non-Muslim men have mistresses, girlfriends and side chicks. Yeah? This is why Islam has come to say no. Because what you're doing is you're abusing those women. What are you doing? You're going and sleeping around with them, giving them a Gucci bag, a few lipstick, bye-bye. Nah. Islam says if you're going to do it, my brother, you do it the right way, you honor her. You go to her father and say, look, I want to marry your daughter. Yes, I'm married again. Now, hear me out. I'm talking from the heart. Yeah? hear me out, yeah? You go to... So what the thing is you go to the father and say, look, I want to marry your daughter. Why? Because you respect her. Not, hey, yeah, let's talk link up. You take none of that nonsense. We are not even allowed to be texting
alone. To be alone. You know why? Because we believe Satan is the third person. Things happen. You know when two people are alone in a certain place, you get what I'm trying to say? So we honor her. We give her her right. We give her a wedding. She has her right. And you have two wives that you treat. You buy an iPhone 5, you buy the next one an iPhone. This is justice.
Ali. Okay. Let me just respond to that because I'm going to go to this.
By the way,
let me just say something.
Yeah. Hey, boy, listen, yeah? Real talk, yeah? Like I said before, I'm here for my ego. If you prove something to me, I accept it. I don't want this to be a discussion.
No.
Yeah? If you're right, I'll say, look, people
yeah,
want
to
hear
your point. I'm just trying to understand the logic.
Let's break this notion of egos.
Because I'm just questioning the logic. Because I want to reveal the... we'll wrap this up very quickly. I just want to... Because it's because when you said certain points, it made me think... Yeah, it made me think of other things. So I'm just going
to.
I'm going to give you the verse, the hadith about where Mutta was. The verse about Mutta was. You give me your opinion. So it says, narrated Abdullah Bukhari, it says, we used to participate in the holy wars carried on by the Prophet, and we had no women with us. So we said to the Prophet, shall we castrate ourselves? But the Prophet forbade us to do that, and thenceforth he allowed us to marry a woman temporarily by giving her even a garment. And then he recited, O you who believe, do not make unlawful the good things which Allah has made lawful to you. Now my question is this: if these men had women, wives at home, and they've gone away to war, and now they're going to engage in a temporary marriage, is this fair to the original wife? And does he have to tell the original wife? Because if he doesn't, we cannot then say this is fairness to the woman, because something's going on between her or him and her. She might be devastated. So one, it's two parts of the question.
Okay, number one. Okay, so what we're going to do is, number one, is that I don't know about this matter.
Okay.
Number one, he's quoted a hadith, which I need to check the context, why it was revealed, how it was revealed. Yeah? Number three, was at the time... This is like me showing you scripture. It's in the Bible. But when was it revealed? Who was it for? Context before and after, yeah?
Wait, yes, gives you the context.
No. It doesn't work. If that's the case, then you'll have these people coming and saying, yeah, kill the disbelievers wherever you find them. But what about the verse before and after?
Well, it told you that they were in the war and that they wanted to engage in sexual intercourse.
No. What was their condition?
They wanted jiggy-jiggy.
How long were they going for? Jiggy-jiggy, you're the one... Okay, so the issue is, if they're going to war, these wars were not like, fam, let me get a fly there, yeah? Years or months to go in there, yeah?
Okay.
That's why they said, should we castrate ourselves?
Yeah.
Yeah?
That could have been after 2 days.
No, you're missing the point. When you're going to war, okay, there's a whole different context to it. So, why it was revealed, why it was prohibited, we need to discuss that in detail, I need to listen to the matter.
Okay.
Yeah? So, that was there, we need to find out, firstly, if that's authentic, if it is, what's the context, I need to know that.
Why, it's Bukhari.
Okay, because Bukhari is authentic, then we need to find out why it was revealed. Next week, I need to get to it.
So you're looking to it, okay, that's fine, that's fine. But my claim is this,
we need to know.
Yeah, we can discuss this properly next
because,
week.
Because these are real issues, because it's easy for us to live in 2019, yeah, and look at the matter back then. No, it was totally different, man. There was a different era. Why would they do certain things? And not only that, if you look at the Romans, the Christians, the Persians, when they were going, forget this says married, married to them. They were going and raping them. Not all Christians. I'm saying there was bad Christians who would go to war, and women, they would rape them like somebody and kill them. So we need to look. Why
would that would happen in Islam as well?
No, they were bad Muslims.
About marriage.
I know you want to get married.
Everyone's asking about your marriage document.
Listen, part one's coming out.
I've seen them.
Yeah. So all of my claim is this. Okay, that if you go
and then you've gone to war
and then you've engaged in an extramarital relationship. So my claim is this is what we discussed next week. I'm saying this is what next week we can just when you've had a look at the verse is that I find it disagreeable that you can go to war. Potentially have an extramarital relationship, even if it's a temporary marriage, behind your wife's back, and you don't even have to tell her. You might even come back with an STD, because that's why I asked you: can you lie to your wife?
What you're doing is you're thinking.
Yeah, but I said when you find out, we'll discuss this further.
But what you're
this
doing
is
now,
for you to ponder.
The way you're putting it is problematic. What you're doing is you're looking at it with the context, the glasses of today.
Yeah, but you said in terms of, yeah, but STDs and sex, yeah, exactly, has been a problem throughout history.
No, no, no.
Of course
we do. No, no, one second. When
it's
back
logical.
In the days, no, 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 it's right. Not logical. 3,000 years ago, let's say 4,000 years ago,
yes.
Or 2,000 years ago,
so you think
people,
were, yes.
No, no, 1 second.
Gonorrhea, chlamydia.
Nobody were, well, there were nations that lived rock up like us, yeah, yeah. Sadly, today, how we live, yeah. But not all nations were like that, yeah. So we shouldn't go and generalize and make it seem that every nation.
But you saying they're like that, it doesn't mean everyone has to be going sleeping around, but like disease were transmitted.
People married.
Yes.
There was a man that they sleep around with 500 men.
Yeah, but I'm saying if you go and engage in mutta, it increases the potentiality of that
happening. The conditions of what mutta was for. Why you got pregnant? That's what I'm saying. You're sticking to it.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, look, we're going to discuss.
No, but I'm saying to you, look, if you marry a woman for 3 days, yes.
You're missing
and
the point.
No, but listen to what I'm saying. You marry a woman for 3 days. Someone else likes her. He marries her for 3 days. Let's say someone else.
This
the logic tells us the potential is there. Do you agree?
Okay, but firstly, we need to look at the conditions.
Don't worry, man.
Okay, so that's what I'm saying. We'll discuss that next
that's
week.
What I'm saying,
yeah,
let's
but
see.
I'm just giving you my thought process behind
that,
it,
that
why I think
flawed.
It's wrong.
You can't say it's wrong until you find out
all right,
exactly
we'll discuss that next
the
week.
Registration.
All right, so next week we're going to discuss mutter marriages and the conditions.
Okay.
Yeah? All right, cool.